Mr. Naar, to the dais.
Short people problems. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. President Shapiro, Provost Linzer, Dean Dennis, members of the Platform Party, faculty, staff, friends and family. No more deadlines. No more filming anymore. No more of, I have permission to film, I swear. Or maybe not. No more Final Cut renderings, or the countless breaks we take because of them. And no more weeping in the middle of Batil for receiving Medil Fs. Thank God for that. But in all seriousness, let us take a step back to the very beginning, day one of orientation. When Deans Roth and Schwach sat us down and asked us the very first question. Why Northwestern? Why communications? Why journalism? Most of us looked around and asked, didn't we already answer this question so many times through the application process? But the answers came. I want to tell stories. I want to help others. I want to travel the world. I want to change the world. That's when Professor Abe looked at us and said, good, because here at Northwestern, you will learn to do exactly that, to give voice to the voiceless. In all honesty, as simple as that phrase may sound, I didn't know what that exactly meant. So this takes me back 2 years ago, when I had my first real lesson in journalism. I had a conversation with a security guard who at 3 in the morning was already feeling the exhaustion of a midnight shift. He looked at me and said, Ismaeel, my friend, work hard and don't end up like me. You see, I never took my ambitions and my education seriously, and look at me now. Over the course of that night, I found out that he had 2 children and a wife back home in Nepal, and that he was sending most of his salary here in Qatar to support them, where his son was just about to graduate from college. His eyes gleamed as he showed me a picture of his son, knowing that because of his hard work here in Qatar, that the future of his son back in Nepal would be just that brighter. You see, his story is no different than my father's or the parents here today. The selfless act of thinking for your children, wanting a better future for them than the ones you had. So that's when I realized that we don't necessarily have to go that far to become storytellers, because we just have to listen to the ones around us. We have the ability to put ourselves in someone else's shoes and the ability to see the world through their eyes. So in doing so, we give someone a voice to the voiceless. Whether it is a communications film that encapsulates the Syrian revolution and the true meaning behind the phrase Mishan al-Hurriya, or for freedom, and what it meant for a son and his mother, or a journalism report under the name Sweet Epidemic on the struggles of a Qatari nation living with diabetes and illness. You see, what we learned here is that stories have the power to move not only one person, but a nation. And what we do here as storytellers can be seen as controversial and hard-hitting, but the end result is that there is dialogue. People here may not be used to putting their problems in the spotlight, but at the end of the day, they're still talking about them. And in a city and a region where many of us are still trying to figure out our problems, the only way to achieve and grow is if we talk with one another. You see, that's the real reason why the work we do works. So 4 years have passed. And in this moment, I'm taking a step back to that very first question. Why communications? Why journalism? And honestly speaking, the answers aren't, should not, be different than they were 4 years ago. So fellow graduates, be storytellers. Help others. Travel the world and tell their stories. And be the change you want to see in the world. Edmund Burke had once said, "All that is necessary for the triumph of evil is when good men do nothing." So let us use our degrees today to do good things in life and contribute back to our societies, wherever they may be. As a final note of gratitude, we remember the people who helped pave the way so that we can stand proudly here today. Thank you to our deans, professors, and staff for giving us a path to our passions, though often not the easiest. To our parents, for supporting, loving, and trusting us in pursuing those passions, even when others in the community were doubting how significant our work could be in our societies. And to those who are not with us here today, my mom included. Mama, I did it. We did it. And finally, to everyone who has shared our journeys with us, thanks for the stories. Class of 2013, congratulations. Elf Mabruk. Go Wildcats.